Hello, and this is the Chin and Jesso in space. But for today's video, I wanted to take you guys on a tour of my sewing corner. Just to let you guys know that you do not need a massive space to get creative. Okay, you can just have a little corner like mine and you're good to go. So I'll just show you how I store my things so that it gives you guys an idea of how you can store yours as well. All right, so I'll just flip the camera
Hey
around
guys,
and
this
we'll
is
start
my
the
video.
little setup. I don't keep my fabric around here either. So if I just swing this way really quick, that's my bed. And if you can see all that on there, I've just covered everything up with the duvet cover. Okay, so let's start from here, shall we? This is a very interesting table. That is the bin. And I don't like having bins everywhere, so I just put that bag so that it's easier for me to take out. Like I take it out very frequently, okay? So over here we have my patterns for myself that I've cut out. This is my trouser pattern, right? This is my skirt pattern. Okay, I should really get something where I can put and stand them up. Then these are brown papers that I use to draft out my patterns, and then when I am 100% sure of the pattern, I transfer them to something harder like this. These are, if you can look very well, these are calendars. Okay, this is my skirt pattern. Sorry, this is a high waist trouser, and this is just my regular trouser. Okay, this is another paper. Then this is the folder I got for my fashion project that I'm doing. Okay, these are my sample fabrics. I have done this one, I have done this one, I have done the skirt of this one, and oh no, I haven't done this one. I've done this is a skirt, this is a pants. And this has been a skirt. So I want to dive in now into some tops, right? And here you can see I just made a list of fabrics and things that I need, just so that this is a sketch of the skirt, the front, the back, and the side view. So it's just something that I used to keep myself organized for that particular project. Okay. Then, what else do I keep here? This is the drawing for the skirt I made, a 6-piece skirt. There's a tutorial of that on YouTube already, but if you've seen the tutorial, you'll recognize this. Then, so what do I do if I'm not doing my fashion project, my fashion collection project. This is where it's very, very disorganized. And I want to say that on Craftsy, I just joined their Seamwork. They have this collab with Seamwork where you can get, all these papers that helps you plan out your projects better, right? But here. Here are my makes. Okay, I made this skirt, I made this into palazzo pants. So I just like, this is so rough and so basic, honestly. Like, I made that. Everything on here I have actually made. See that? I've made that into a dress. It's this part of my remake your ready to wear project. Okay. This was part of it, but I haven't finished making it yet. But this was for my mom, I made that for her. This was my Minerva project, I've made that. Check me out on Minerva, I'll try and put a link for that project. This is a dress I'm making that I have not yet done with, sadly. So basically, that's just it. This is another Minerva project, you see, Minerva dress. I have finished this also on the Minerva site. So, very, very basic. And I'm happy that Seamwork, I joined Seamwork, and they gave they're giving, what's it called? You know, like templates for things so that you're more organized. Then here is where I'm keeping all the fabrics that I'm using for my personal sewing project, just so that I see them and it makes me, keeps me motivated to sew, right? And this in here is the things I'm using, like the zips and the threads and all that good stuff. So in here is what I'm currently, like here is where I keep my rulers. I don't have a lot, just this, and I have this curved ruler that I got to print online and just cut it out and put it on this cardboard box, because I tried buying it on Amazon and it cost like 3 times the amount to send such a tiny thing. It was like $2 and it was costing me almost $10 to ship. And I have these rulers here. So back to this box. So this is what I'm making my last project for Minerva. So if you follow me on Instagram, right, you should see my latest update on this project. And because I'm not working on this part yet, the parts I'm working on are on the chair, you see them. So yeah, that's why they're in here. And these are, is the remnants of the fabric, just in case I need something else, right? I can go in there. Then there was a wedding I was planning for, and I was going to finish making that before I made this, but I ran into some problems, so I cut the wrong thing, and basically I couldn't wear that dress anymore. And this is the green dress I was talking about. So basically, this is for works in progress currently. Then over here, we have it's something like a moulage, but for, hold on, let me show you guys. So like I was saying, it's literally a pattern for my top. Right, there's this lady I follow on YouTube. She has a course on how to draft your basic bodice pattern, and I bought the course, and this is what you get if you follow that particular course. So I drafted mine and I love it. It's what I've been working with since. So it's just here in case anytime I need it, I get it out and I get the brown paper and, you know, transfer the drawings and make alterations on the brown paper. Okay. Now, moving on, ladies and gents, to my next corner in my sewing corner. This is the corner I used to sew for my Mpizal dressmaker 270D. Okay, this is the famous sewing machine. I have a whole bunch of tutorials on how to set it up, how to thread, how to everything. But I don't have any tutorial on how to clean and oil, and I've been getting a lot of requests on that. So I was thinking that I could do like a YouTube live of me cleaning and oiling this machine, because it doesn't really say on the manual, and I think I do mine just a little bit differently. So if you're interested, please in the comments write interested, so I know, like, if enough people are interested, then I'll do a YouTube live. Okay, all right, so moving on, this is actually something I bought so I could do overhead better overhead shots for my tutorials. This is what it's called. Let me see. Put it down properly. So this is what it's called. And yeah, so I haven't had the chance to use it, but if we're going to do that YouTube live, then I'll probably whip it out to use. So this is the star of my sewing machine. Of my sewing machines, I have only two. This is the Brother Innovis 35P. Again, I have a tutorial, I have an unboxing, and I have a review of the sewing machine. I'll put it up in the cards. Then I also just made this because the people I bought from didn't have an extension table, and I wasn't about to go to Amazon and buy just an extension table. Okay, so I made this. This is my own extension table. There's also a tutorial for how that is done. I'll link that up in the cards for you guys. But yeah, the machine just sits here, and I have my light, and I'll switch it on for you guys. And let me tell all of you, okay, no matter how well you think your sewing machine is lit, you need external lighting. Trust me. Like, you think you don't need it, but I'm telling you, you need one. So get one, okay? You can get anything. These I just got from the game store here in Nigeria. And this is my chair, nothing fancy, just a plastic chair. I do want one of those chairs that, you know, is good for your back and whatnot, right? But like the top I'm working for, Minerva, this is the top part that I'm still working on. So it's on the chair here. And this is that dress I was making to go to a wedding, but I caught something wrong. So I don't know what I'm doing with it yet. If it's abandoned or not, I don't know. So here is the other and interesting end of my sewing machine, sewing corner, sorry. These are, let me jump back here. This is where I put my needles and stuff, and I like it because my seam ripper fits in here, and I can, like I was saying, I can actually take out the lid. This is for a wristwatch, and cover it up if I am traveling or anything like that. So that's why I really like this particular arrangement for my pins and whatnot, and my chalk. And these are my two most used bias tape makers. Okay, so we now get to the another interesting end, and this is actually light I also use for filming, but I don't think it makes any difference now. So in here I have my sewing threads. Okay, in here I have my, this is for my needles. Okay, I just made something real quick and put so that I know where my needles are, because I kept on losing them and having to use brand new needles every single time. So this 9 regular, 10 regular, you know, 12 stretch, 10 stretch. And I just keep that in here. Okay. So these are my bobbins. You know, the MPZL uses metal bobbins, so I have a bit of those. But the Brother uses plastic bobbins. Okay, then these are my threads. They are color coded, and I put them in these Ziploc bags. Before, they used to just be, you know, tumbling around in here, and I found out that they were tangling, so I didn't like that one bit. So like I said, they are color coded, mostly blacks, blues. Never knew I had so many blue threads, and blue is not my favorite color, and I don't think I sew that, even green. Like, I don't sew that much green, but I guess the colors, this is like a spare, the colors must be very eye-catching to me. Then these are my top stitching threads. Okay, so yeah, I keep them organized that way. And it saved me a lot of time from untangling threads and whatnot. Okay, so in this drawer, I have, what do I have in here? I have my needles, I have my buttons. Okay, because you get on Instagram and you see even some YouTube channels and you see this big glass jar with all the buttons thrown in there, and it looks nice and fancy, but trust me, when you want to pick out things in a hurry, it's the most annoying thing, because what that means is that you have to chuck out all your buttons and start checking for them. That is not functional at all. This is more functional. I need to get another one. And I don't like buy buttons and keep. I buy as projects that I want come up that I'm working on. I mean, I do have some that I bought because I liked the way they look, but basically I'm not a button holder or anything like that. Yeah, then this is for what you call it, piping. I like the soft kind. Yeah, these are just odds and ends. Right. Oh, then I also have in here is my foot. Right. I bought this on Jumia in Nigeria. So yeah, that's for that drawer. Then for this drawer, I have my ribbons, my bias tapes that I've already made, I made myself. And bias bindings are like my favorite finishes. And I have elastics. I don't know why. Like, I buy elastics, I buy a lot of elastics. Then these are my zips. Okay. These are just some office supplies I have. And I use this to make a dress. These are like embellishments that I used to make a dress for my brother's wedding. So this is like what's left. And these are horse hair braids. Okay. So that's that for that drawer. These are my cotton linings. And these I do buy whenever I see, because they're especially the good quality ones. I prefer them to those polyester linings. Then let's go here. This is my case where I put my lint roller, scissors, a brush for cleaning the machine. This is the dress I'm making for Minerva. Like I said again, very, very horrible draft. Yeah. Then inside here are my works, abandoned projects, works in projects for years and years and years. We won't go in there, please. Then here is my, what you may call them now. In Nigeria, we call them gum stay, but basically, those things that have the gummy side. Yeah, I will remember the name and put it on the screen. Then here is also my linings, but the like polyester ones that I use them to make skirts or for places where I will not be sweating. Then these are my linings as well, but the stretchy ones. Okay, so that I have them all separated and it's easy for me to pick out. So yeah, this is like an overview of my sewing corner. I hope I've really given you guys an idea or ideas of how to make your own like sewing room or sewing corner your own, you know. But I don't keep my fabrics here because, as you can see, there's no space. So I keep that in my closet actually. So I will just take you guys in there and show you what I do there. Okay. I do apologize for the lightning in here. Let's take this out. Just here. So this is how I arrange my fabrics. This way it's just easier to pull out. You know, I see what I have and it's easier to pull them out. I've been a bit messy of late, but you guys get the idea, right? Okay, so like I want an orange fabric, boom, it's there. I want, this is a chambray fabric, right? So it's easier this way. I know some people have theirs folded, but if you don't have a lot of space, this is the easiest way you can do it and, you know, be able to be functional and see your fabrics as they are. Okay? Okay then. So we are back here, guys, and yeah, I just wanted to say thank you for sticking with me to the end. Remember, if you're interested in the live cleaning and oiling session of the M-Pizza Dressmaker, write interested in the comment section so I know you're interested. And until then, sew and subscribe.